I don't give a shit about football, but Cristiano seems to be an impressive dude. He won the Ballon d'Or 5 times, he has been celebrated as the top scorer 15 times in his career, and he won the Champions League with Real and ManU 4 times. What few people know though is that Cristiano Ronaldo was actually born in poverty in a town called Madeira, and only with incredible ambition, will and belief in himself, he managed to get out of this slump. But we also have to realize that there's a fine line between self-belief and arrogance. Here's three key lessons that we can learn from Ronaldo. I've watched a couple documentaries about Ronaldo. What you will find is that 1. Cristiano has a tendency to freaking cry a lot. 2. Cristiano loves his family. And 3. Ronaldo has an incredible will to win. The movie of Ronaldo starts with the following words.
Winning. That's the most important to me. It's as simple as that.
Cristiano plays games with injuries and feels an incredible obligation to his country, manager, family and team. This need to win was fostered when Ronaldo was living in poverty. Everything Ronaldo has to this day was made through winning. Cristiano simply has to win to maintain his lifestyle. Winning stems from a necessity in his case. I've met a guy on my trip to Thailand a couple years ago that was a martial artist, and he told me that his hardest professional fights were in Thailand, as the people that you have to fight there on a daily basis are willing to die in the ring. They have nothing to lose and everything to gain. This is the same thing with Cristiano Ronaldo when he was younger. His dad went to war and came back with an alcohol addiction, probably suffering from PTSD. Cristiano had to win to create a life for himself and his family. There was no other option. The first lesson that we can learn from Ronaldo is necessity. Robert Greene, a famous author, calls necessity the ruler of the world, as people only act when they need to. Ronaldo did need to act, and so should you. Take risks, create deadlines, and social pressure to foster necessity in your life. This is the only thing that will keep you going. Due to this necessity and early experiences with football, Ronaldo had to develop a mindset of greatness. He's not afraid to state multiple times that he's the best footballer in this world.
Are you the best footballer in the world right now?
I think so, yes. In my mind, I'm always the best. I don't care what the people thinking, what they say. In my mind, not just this year, but always, I'm always the best. I'm always gonna say that.
But this isn't really arrogance, which definition is an overbearing pride. The saying that he's the best footballer is merely a fact. As Ronaldo has won the Ballon d'Or multiple times, he truly is the best footballer in this world. But I'm pretty sure that Cristiano has called himself the best footballer years ago when he wasn't the best. Or as Muhammad Ali said, I called myself the best even though I wasn't.
I am the greatest!
Or look at an old video of Conor McGregor, now one of the best fighters in the world.
I'm a professional MMA fighter with a record of 4-1. I'm an up-and-coming fighter, and without a doubt you will see me on the UFC in the near future, without a doubt.
The truth is that you have to believe in yourself if you want to achieve anything extraordinary in this world. Look at the Champions League final in 2014, up until the 19th minute Real Madrid was losing. Di Maria lost his hope and was planting his head in the grass, while Ronaldo believed in Real and was still sure that they would win the match.
And I speak with him and I say, come on, let's go, because I believe that we're gonna score a goal.
Real won 4-1. This is an extreme example of self-belief. The belief in yourself is the fundament for your actions. If you've lost hope, you will plant your head in the grass and not act accordingly, because action is crucial. Love or hate Ronaldo, but you can't lie that he's great at what he does. His accomplishments truly speak for themselves. He got a great athletic body and is the freaking top player of his team Portugal, so much that he got special privilege. You can only develop this ability by hours and hours of deliberate practice.
Skill is only developed by hours and hours and hours of being. crap.
If you truly think about it, self-belief is arrogance when your actions don't match your belief. Imagine Cristiano Ronaldo telling the audience, "I'm the best footballer," but he then will play video games all day long. If Cristiano Ronaldo states that he's the best and then goes on to win the Ballon d'Or, he was just stating the facts. Of course, this is not humble behavior, but this self-belief is what's the driving force of his actions. Stop trying to please everyone. Believe in yourself and then act accordingly. Cristiano Ronaldo is not perfect. He lost hundreds of games, missed thousands of shots, probably made a child with a waitress while drunk, and cries like a pussy all the freaking time. Yet all these setbacks didn't stop him from making a name for himself. The poverty created a necessity in him, which fostered great ambition. For that ambition, he needed self-belief, which most importantly led to action. Action and self-belief have to go together, because if they don't, you look like an arrogant prick. Who cares if you say loud that you're gonna be a millionaire if you're ready to work 80 plus hours a week for 10 years? You can say that you want to be in great shape if this makes it more likely for you to spend at least 3 hours a week in the gym for a couple of years. Your actions have to match your belief. Don't worry about offending someone. You can't please everybody. Focus on you. Now, what are you waiting for? You got great stuff to do.